Hello everyone, another quick video about SAFlexo. This time we're going to cover this ticket, how to open a reference property detail view by clicking on the cell on the list view. So let's see the image here. So pretty much let's say that we have a customer, we're going to click on here and we're going to open the detail view of that customer. So the only thing that I did here besides reading this amazing ticket was download the sample project that they have here, and pretty much the idea is pretty smart. If you see, we are going to create our own result component. We're going to inject the application provider, and with the application provider, we can get the detail view ID from the member type, and we're going to pass the key. And the UI that we will have is pretty much this href that will target the URL that we're passing in here. Does that make sense? After that, we're going to use a custom lookup property editor that we're inheriting from the lookup property editor. And this is really neat. We're gonna tag in the create view components code, get the result there, then get the key of that object. And with that one, we can have the default render fragment, we can have the member type, the key. We will have everything that we need to construct this. And if you see, pretty much those are the three parameters that you need. The default render fragment that is already being done by the local property editor, the member type, and the key. So let's see it in action. If you see here, this is the zip that I downloaded. I haven't done anything on it. And we have two business objects, task that has a reference, that is the employee, and employee that has a collection of tasks. That's it. So as we were seeing in the ticket, we have our render that pretty much is just an href with this get URL that we're going to open a new tab, and we're going to show the default render fragment. So as the parameter, we will have the default render fragment, the member type that we need to use to get the detail view ID, and the key of that object. So when we call the create, we're going to be passing these three parameters. So if we go to the custom local property editor, this is really nice because we're going to hook up into the create view component code that will return us a render fragment for us. So we have the default render fragment. Then we're going to get the current object because we need it to get the key. And when we get the key, then we're going to have the default render fragment, the member type, and the key. And that's all we need. And of course, we're going to make it true so it's available all across the application. So if we run this, we went to the other monitor. And if we check, we have on our task a reference property of employee. So if we go to task, you see that we are showing now hyperlinks. That if we click on it, it will take us to the detail view. And we're passing the key of that object. Really neat, right? Okay, that's all for this video. Quick and to the point. See you in the next one.